Dear students, we are in the fourth session of the Z transform. Let us concentrate on inverse Z transform. For a given Z transform capital FZ and the region of convergence, identifying the sequence small fk such that Z transform of small fk equal to capital FZ is called finding the inverse Z transform. There are three methods to find the inverse Z transform: power series method, method of partial fractions, and the inversion integral method. So we'll discuss this problem by the first method. Find the inverse Z transform for capital FZ equal to Z upon Z minus A when modulus of Z greater than modulus of A and modulus of Z less than modulus of A. Already we know the answers. These are two problems. Let us see the first problem. Z transform is Z upon Z minus A and region of convergence is modulus of Z greater than modulus of A. That means modulus of A by Z less than 1. So accordingly, we will be expressing this in terms of A by Z. So let us divide both numerator and denominator by Z. 1 upon 1 minus A upon Z with absolute value of A by Z less than 1. So the infinite geometric expansion is 1 plus a by z to the power 1 plus a by z to the power 2 plus a by z to the power 3 and so on. So we can write this in the form of summation. This is summation k from 0 to infinity a to the power k upon z to the power k. So we see that whenever there is z to the power k in denominator, in numerator we must have a to the power k. And as such, when we put k equal to 0, then we are getting the first term as 1. And we have to cover remaining values of k also, which are k from minus infinity to minus 1. And there is no corresponding term, so that must be equal to 0. So the sequence, by the definition of the Z transform, must be a to the power k, k greater than or equal to 0, and 0 for k less than 0. Next problem, Z transform is the same but region of convergence is different. So here modulus of Z by A less than 1. So let us divide both numerator and denominator by A and we are getting this. So little adjustment, minus Z by A times 1 upon 1 minus Z by A with absolute value of Z by A less than 1. So this will be equal to minus Z by A outside. Then the infinite geometric expansion, 1 plus z by a plus z by a square plus z by a cube and so on. So multiplying, so these are the different terms. After that, let us write the common term, summation. So we are seeing that powers of z are coming in numerator. In the last problem, the powers of z were in denominator. So let us say that z to the power r, when z to the power r is there, in denominator there is a to the power r and every term has negative sign r. R is equal to 1 to infinity. Now we want powers of z in denominator, so we are making the substitution, put k equal to minus r, and that is equal to summation k. When r equal to 1, k becomes minus 1. When r equal to infinity, k becomes minus infinity. So summation k from minus 1 to minus infinity minus z to the power minus k upon e to the power minus k. So we know that addition is commutative, so we can say summation k from minus infinity to minus 1 minus a to the power k upon z to the power k plus, for remaining values of k from 0 to infinity, small f k equal to 0 upon z to the power k, and the sequence is minus a to the power k, k less than 0 and 0 for k greater than equal to 0. Thus we have again understood that even though the Z transform is the same, if region of convergence changes, accordingly we are getting different sequence. Next problem, find inverse Z transform of Z upon Z minus 1 into Z minus 2 for So first situation, modulus of z is greater than 2. So then second is modulus of z less than 1, and third 1 less than modulus of z, and modulus of z less than 2. So even though z transform is the same, under three different conditions we will be getting three different sequences. But for all these three problems, whatever is the common thing, we are going to write that. In this, we are going to solve this problem by the method of partial fractions. In this, we are writing capital FZ first. In the next step, we are dividing everything by Z. Capital FZ upon Z is equal to 1 upon Z minus 1 into Z minus 2. And here, we must have degree of numerator smaller than degree of denominator. Then we can go for partial fractions. Fortunately, denominator is product of two factors, and here we see there is 1, and the difference between the two factors is also 1. So absolutely no need to say that this is equal to a upon z minus 1 plus b upon z minus 2. We can directly write this as 1 upon z minus 2 minus 1 upon z minus 1. We have written the partial fractions. After that, multiply everything by z. Therefore, capital FZ equal to z upon z minus 2 minus z upon z minus 1. Now, we are getting this as a linear combination of two z transforms. Inverse z transform is also linear. So, that means the inverse z transform of capital FZ is equal to inverse z transform of this first z transform minus inverse z transform of the second z transform. Applying the inverse z transform, so this much is common for all the three situations, and after that let us concentrate on the first condition, modulus of z greater than 2. So inverse z transform of capital FZ is sequence fk, that is equal to, now z transform must be z upon z minus 2 and modulus of z greater than 2, so the sequence must be 2 to the power k with k greater than or equal to 0 minus. Now we are not given any condition between 1 and modulus of z. Here z transform is z upon z minus 1. But we know that 2 is greater than 1, and using commutative property we can say that modulus of z is greater than 1 and z transform is z upon z minus 1. So the sequence must be 1 to the power k, k greater than or equal to 0, and thus we can write small fk equal to 2 to the power k minus 1, k greater than or equal to 0, and 0 otherwise. The second situation, modulus of z less than 1. So again, from this step, inverse z transform of capital FZ is equal to sequence small fk equal to, now the z transform is z upon z minus 2 and modulus of z is less than 2, so the sequence must be minus 2 to the power k for k less than 0 minus. Now the z transform is z upon z minus 1 and modulus of z is less than 1. So we must have the sequence as minus 1 to the power k for k less than 1. So let us write it neatly. Sequence small fk equal to 1 minus 2 to the power k, k less than 0 and 0 otherwise. The third situation, 1 less than modulus of z less than 2. So again, from that step, inverse z transform of capital FZ equal to sequence small fk equal to, now the z transform is z upon z minus 2, modulus of z is less than 2. So the sequence must be minus 2 to the power k with k less than 0 minus. Now z transform is z upon z minus 1, modulus of z is greater than 1, so the sequence must be 1 to the power k with k greater than or equal to 0. And thus our answer, the sequence is equal to minus 2 to the power k for k less than 0 and minus 1 for k greater than or equal to 0. Next problem, find inverse z transform of z square upon z square plus 1 for modulus of z greater than 1. Here capital FZ equal to z square plus 1 with modulus of z greater than 1. So again, we will be going by the method of partial fractions. Capital FZ is z square upon the factors of z square plus 1 r, that is z minus I and z plus I. Now we know that modulus of I is equal to 1, modulus of minus I is also equal to 1. So from this given information, which is modulus of z greater than 1, we can say modulus of z greater than modulus of I and modulus of z greater than modulus of minus I. So in partial fractions method, divide this entire equation by z first. Capital F z upon z is equal to z upon z minus I into z plus I, and that is equal to, now here in numerator there is z, so instead of minus we will be saying plus here, so we are getting half times 1 upon z minus I plus 1 upon z plus I. Otherwise you can say here that is equal to a upon z minus I plus b upon z plus I, and you can find values of a and b, and you will be getting value of a as 1 by 2 and value of b also as 1 by 2. We can write directly also. Then multiply by z, capital F z equal to half times z upon z minus I plus z upon z plus I, and let us apply inverse z transform. Inverse z transform of capital F z is equal to 1 by 2 completely outside, inverse z transform of z upon z minus I plus inverse z transform of z upon z plus I. Therefore the sequence small f k equal to half times z transform is z upon z minus I, and modulus of z is greater than modulus of I. So the sequence must be I to the power k with k greater than or equal to 0 plus. Now the z transform is z upon z minus minus I with the condition modulus of z greater than modulus of minus I. So the sequence must be minus I whole to the power k, k greater than equal to 0. And thus the sequence small f k equal to half times I to the power k plus minus I to the power k, k greater than equal to 0. And we know that this I is a complex number whose real part is 0 and imaginary part is 1. That's why r is equal to 1 and theta is equal to pi by 2. So we can write I always as e to the power I times pi by 2. And minus I is its complex conjugate. R is equal to 1 and theta will be equal to minus pi by 2. So minus I is equal to e to the power minus I times pi by 2. So putting condition remains the same. And in the next step, small f k equal to half times e to the power I times k times pi by 2 plus e to the power I times minus I k pi by 2, k greater than equal to 0. And we know the formula that e to the power I times theta plus e to the power minus I times theta upon 2 is equal to cos of theta. So here theta equal to k times pi by 2. So if k equal to cos of k times pi by 2, k greater than equal to 0. Let us have a pause here.